Hello, my name is Marites Kingona Africa. I am a lay Catholic and I have been engaged in the field of interreligious dialogue for over 20 years. I first became aware of this field in 1998 when I met a friend who was then working for an international peace organization and was in Manila for a visit. I was then a graduate student at the Loyola School of Theology and was rather uncertain about where my theological studies would take me. As I listened to my friend talk about his experiences in the field, I was struck not so much by what I heard, but by what I saw. He was wearing a white t-shirt, and on it was printed the image of the globe, surrounded by the different symbols of the religions of the world. That image struck me so much, provoked in me many questions about my faith, and I asked myself, what is unique about the Christian faith amid all of the different faiths in the world? What does it mean to be Catholic Christian in the world today? And why do people of faith fight each other in the name of God? As I sought for answers to those questions, I found myself getting deeper and deeper into the journey of seeking to find the heart of my Christian faith. I was restless inside. Something in me urged me to get out of myself, to reach out beyond my fears, beyond my comfort zones, to others who did not share my beliefs, and get to know them. In 1998, interreligious dialogue was not yet well known. And since I was beginning in it, I didn't know anyone. I have always taken for granted that everyone I met was Catholic. So I searched the yellow pages of the phone directory and was rather surprised to find a number of religions listed in it. In my enthusiasm, I reached out to them and invited them to come to my home for a get-together. I later realized how naive I was in even thinking that they would come. I and my motives must have come across to them as suspect, and they did not accept my invitation. Some responded with angry words. This was my very first experience of fear in dialogue, in religion, and I was a little taken aback, but I was young and I didn't let their rejection discourage me. Instead, I told myself that if they would not come, I would go to them. So I decided to take a 6-month pilgrimage of faith that took me to places of worship and spiritual centers of gatherings around Metro Manila. I visited Muslims in their mosque, Taoists and Hindus in their temples, Buddhist monks in their sanghas, and it was then that I learned that there was such a religion called Baha'i. So interested was I in learning about other religions that I asked them questions about their cultures and beliefs, and they gladly opened to me and introduced me to their faiths and the teachings of their faiths and ideals. It was an exciting experience for me, and I even offered to give English lessons to Tibetan Buddhist monks in exchange for lessons in Buddhism. I visited my newfound friends not only once, not only twice, but many times throughout the succeeding years. It was not easy to wade through the traffic of Metro Manila, but I was richly rewarded for my efforts. Not only did I gain a deeper insight, understanding, and appreciation for their cultures and beliefs, I gained their friendship, their trust, their respect. And then we became steadfast companions in the interfaith journey from then on. In 2001, I founded the Peacemaker Circle Foundation together with my friends of diverse religions, spiritual expressions, and indigenous traditions. It was a non-profit NGO based in Manila that promoted various forms of dialogue as a way of building relationships of mutual respect, understanding, and cooperation among peoples of diverse cultures and beliefs. We practice dialogue of life and encourage the people in the community, in the grassroots community, each other with respect and as human beings. We practice dialogue of action and encourage them to work together to address various problems and concerns in their communities. We practice dialogue of worship as they began to get to know each other and wanted to be in solidarity with each other as they worshiped and celebrated their holidays, their celebrations of faith. And we practiced dialogue of discourse, theological discourse. So for them to deepen their understanding of each other's faiths and deepen their friendships and respect for one another. We also devoted much of our time into serving the interests of peace in conflict-affected and poverty-stricken grassroots communities where Muslims and Christians live alongside each other as neighbors. With the help of some members of the diplomatic community, we were able to visit different communities around Metro Manila and in North Cotabato, Mindanao, where conflict was rife, and to build relationships of mutual respect, understanding, and cooperation between Muslims and Christians there, while we were able to gain good measures of success through the years. Our work has not been easy. One of the biggest challenges that we have had to face was fear, the fear of the other, and attitudes of prejudice and discrimination that prevailed even among my fellow Catholics. I could understand the fear. I was born and raised in Mindanao, where as a child, I learned to be afraid of Muslims. They were called Moros. It was a pejorative term that was used to frighten us children into obeying the elders in our homes. Many years later, as we at the Peacemaker Circle carried on with our work, I learned that fear and love are two opposing forces that cannot coexist at the same time and in the same space. Fear contracts, love expands. Our Christian faith teaches us that perfect love cast out fear, and this enables us to love others as Christ would, and to humanize others, not demonize them as enemies. In this light, I saw my faith as teaching us that being human is okay, that in Jesus Christ, God became human like us, like all of us, and Christ said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." This is a very liberating message for me because I took it to me that God was saying that being human is okay. It is the way to the truth about who we are. That we are in this world, but we are not of the world. That there is life eternal in God in the hereafter. So all of us people of faith, whatever our culture or belief may be, we are all fellow human beings journeying through life towards fullness in God. No matter what our race, our culture, our creed may be, we are created in the image and likeness of God. No matter our differences, we are visible manifestations of the invisible God. And there is something in us that Pope Francis called the transcendent dignity that we must honor and not violate. So in this light of knowing our common humanity under God, whom we call by different names or worship in different ways, our church, as described by Pope Francis so beautifully, is a family among families, upholding in high esteem the workings of God also in others, rejecting nothing that is true and valuable in their religions, but upholding and holding in high regard their manner of life and conduct, their precepts and doctrines. Pope Francis, our Holy Father, also reminded us to offer common witness to the love of God for all human beings, for all of us, all people, by working together in the service of humanity. So this to me is a very inspiring message, inspiring way of understanding my faith, for it liberated me from fear and have made me experience how truly universal my Christian faith is, and helped me to reach out to others despite our differences in the spirit of love and not fear. So if we choose in favor of loving others as Christ loved, we will be able to see and appreciate our differences and be enriched by them. Engaging in interreligious dialogue and promoting it is not easy. I'm very grateful to our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for Fratelli Tutti, his encyclical on human fraternity and social friendships. In it, he issues an urgent message to all people of faith to reach out to one another in the spirit of mutual respect, understanding, and cooperation despite our differences, and love each other as Christ loves. In this chapter, our Holy Father highlights the importance of the contributions of the different religions and the significance of the role of dialogue between them. In my experience, in the field of building relationships among people of diverse cultures and beliefs, dialogue is not merely the exchange of words. It is not even an academic exercise that subscribes to logic and reason. One need not study formally to be able to engage in dialogue and hope to be successful in it. For dialogue is an experience of the heart, and essential to it is heart listening. And to be able to develop this capacity for listening with the heart rightly, one needs to go through a conversion of the heart to the goodness of God in the other, no matter what culture and beliefs they might practice or subscribe to. So conversion of the heart is essential to dialogue. Interfaith dialogue is about building human relationships, not only among followers of mainstream religions, but also spiritual expressions and indigenous traditions. This is a response to the appeal of our Holy Father, Fratelli Tutti, for us to adopt a culture of dialogue as the path, mutual cooperation as the code of conduct, and reciprocal understanding as the method and standard in our daily lives. May we find the courage of heart to respond to this call in the spirit of kinship and love, so that a new and peaceful world may come to be, where we are all living together respectfully as brothers and sisters, despite our differences. I end my sharing with this 2013 video of Muslims and Christians in the community of Tala in Caloocan City, reaching out to one another in the spirit of kinship and love. Thank you for watching.
When I am down and my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burdened be, and I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. Shoulders. You raise me up to more than I.